Sure. He said, sure, why not? So in planning this, I kind of patterned it after one of my professors in college. We did a concert one time where he took the Kyrie from the Catholic Mass, and we did it six ways. Well, today we're going to do the Reformation hymn five different ways. So if it's your favorite hymn, today is a bonus. If it's a hymn that you're feeling okay about, you can enjoy it five ways. The first that we're going to hear is, it's an organ prelude written by Bach. It was written about 1708, and this specific one, we don't exactly know when it was written, but we're guessing that it was written around 1708 because an organ renovation that he supervised in Arnstadt, Weimar, a church that I believe is called Blasius Kirche, not the best German, but that organ was finished about the same time, and the keyboard requirements, three keyboards and pedals, and then the registration suggestions, all were new to that organ in that renovation. So that's why they're kind of marrying those two ideas together with the year and the completion of the organ. Our organ, I don't know that it necessarily has the registrations. I know the copy I gave to Mrs. Cujo doesn't have them. So there are registrations that she's chosen to bring out the best in our organ. The second one I want to comment on is in the anthem spot is a piece called Here I Stand. I like this one because it's Luther's famous quote, "Here I stand, I can do no other." And it expresses his deep understanding of God's word as a matter of conscience. And I'm kind of laughing because any English teacher out there will hate this quote, but I saw a modern quote somebody said, his words are, "Here I stand in my belief. I cannot not believe what I believe." The double negative there is kind of odd, but that will be the anthem piece, and so you will hear part of the Mighty Fortress in that. As the sermon hymn, we'll be doing a piece called Fanfare and Concertato on A Mighty Fortress Is Our God. That one has three verses for the congregation to sing. They'll be up on the screen. Two verses are linked together in the middle, and then there's one at the end. Concertato is a style of music that would have been, had its early beginnings when Luther was still living. But its height in composition and performance would have been when Bach was alive. This is a modern version of a concertato. Concertato is one or more instruments on a theme that are alternating between, taking turns. And then within that genre, you also have the hymn concertato. The theme is a specific featured hymn. And then it always ends with a congregational verse, as does this one. Even though this is kind of in the spot for the sermon hymn, and we're having you sing with us, if you could stay seated for that, it might be a little easier for you to see me conducting and be able to see the choir singing as well. The fourth one is the string quartet we have. They're called the Ladies String Quartet, and they have an extra member with them today.